Ella has always been a different kid. She never cared about what her peers did or said or thought. She follows her own rules, you know, her own drummer, whatever you want to call it. And she wanted her own look, her own style, and she wanted to be unique. And she does things in her own timeline.
And that timeline meant no college. Straight out of high school, Ella Shao's on a path to a biotech career.
So when you're making a cell culture, you want it to be as neutral as possible a lot of the time. So you have to measure to make sure, because if it's too acidic, if it's too basic, they'll also die.
Ella didn't want to start racking up college debt before she knew what she wanted to do.
Steve and I didn't have the opportunity to graduate from college because we both ran out of money.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're being quite honest, right? So we were saddled with so much debt, and there was such a stigma back then that you had to go to college, you had to go to college, you had to go to college.
But the old rules are changing, and Ella found a program that could help her go from high school to hired in one of the state's biggest industries.
In Massachusetts, we are proud to be the global hub of life sciences.
Number one in life sciences.
The global epicenter for life sciences.
But to keep that spot, the industry needs more workers. Life science jobs in Massachusetts are expected to grow 25% over the next 5 years. So, as more young people question the need for college, the industry is too.
You don't need those advanced degrees to succeed in this industry.
It's part of us in biotech getting out of the mindset that you need the four-year college degree.
The science has this, like, I think needs this demystification. It's not this complicated monster that only select people can do.
Guys, this is so easy and fun.
To fill those entry-level jobs, there's now a focus on skills, not degrees. It's opening doors.
I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do with my future. I really didn't want to spend all of the money just to figure out what I want to do. And I see a lot of my peers that have gone to college have gone and have been unhappy with their decision, and it's left them in debt, and it's a major commitment, really.
Come on over here and we'll have a bit of an orientation.
And like Ella Shao, Brady found the Gloucester Biotechnology Academy.
Before this, I only really worked like food jobs, made pizzas, 7-Eleven, random corner store, stuff like that, just to pay the bills. And it's nice that work can be more than that.
A lot of us have only worked things like, which is still hard jobs, but restaurant industry. I've been at Starbucks for a long time, but it's definitely not a career that I want to have for all my life.
They fly under the radar, right? They're those people who are doing the jobs in the gig economy and working in the malls and in the service industry and restaurants and things. And they're behind the scenes and incredibly talented people that we never think about, because why? Why not? Why not them? Because they don't have a bachelor's degree or didn't follow the traditional path that we sort of groom students in this country to follow.
And so your extraction buffer needs 25 millimole interest, right?
Many of them don't necessarily believe in the idea of college. They want hands-on, skills-based training. If you're given a skill, nobody can take that away from you, right? You have that skill, it's yours now, and you can do what you want with it, and they like that idea.
When I first got here, I was so scared to pick up a pipette. Like, what if I'm doing this wrong? What if I'm holding this wrong? What if a chemical gets on me and I get sick? But now I'm very comfortable with all the machines and such. It's a scary transition, because sometimes when you like something so much, you want to be so good at it and you're so passionate about it that you just want to do well.
I think it's definitely changed my life. I don't think I would be on my own or be in a position where I would be able to live on my own without the academy. I've learned about finances, workplace relationships, so much to do with like just jobs in general and just life in general.
After 7 months of training, the students moved into paid internships. Ella Shao's in a lab at Northeastern University.
I have 11 years of experience in the industry, but I work with people with PhDs, postdocs, and I see people like Ella that don't have necessarily all these degrees, but they have that same scientific reasoning ability.
Brady Barry got an internship at the startup Rev Bio, which is developing a synthetic bone adhesive.
I see students coming out of undergrad programs that know a lot of the theory behind the mechanisms that we look at, but Brady's got the hands-on experience where he wants to get into the lab, do things. It opens our eyes into who we can bring on for these different roles. 10.43.
at the beginning, it was very challenging, I think, mainly just in my mentality. I didn't really believe in myself, but I'm realizing, I don't know, I'm like qualified to be here. And you kind of have to overcome that inner monologue, kind of telling yourself that you really don't deserve to be there. But the truth is, I've worked to be here and I'm qualified to do what I do. People on my team rely on me, and that's very nice.
We're missing a talent pool out there. And until we start to tap into it, not only biotech, but industries all over the country are going to miss out on filling those entry-level roles that they're so desperate to hire in.
And Ella and Brady have no regrets about not making the jump to college.
It was really daunting the first couple of dates. I was really nervous, but then once I got to working, I'm like, oh, I know what I'm doing.